and what's news around the world today.
Some wisdom skills along the way.
Oh, and a song to come along with and sway.
Get your perfect editing start of the day.
At 9 a.m. every weekday morning with
Mahima's
Good Morning Bay.
गुड मॉर्निंग बे, आप सभी लोग हमारी तरफ से एक प्यार भरा नमस्ते,
नमस्कार,
वणकम,
नमस्कार,
खुश आमदी,
सलामुलेकुम,
सत श्री अकाल,
जय
स्वामी नारायण,
जय श्री कृष्णा,
जय जनेंद्रा।
मैं इस्माइली भाई बंधुओं को बोल दे याली मदद,
मोला अली मदद बोलते हैं सारे फीजी बंधु लोग, बोलेगा नीसा बोला बनुजान। हम आ गए हैं आपके प्यारे महिमा के द्वारे, मैं फालतू बाबा
एंड ऑफ कोर्स माय सेल्फ फालतू रानी, लेकर आपके लिए और ड्राइव टाइम दैट्स गोना मेक इट टोटली फनफॉर्मेशनल एंड मस्तानी बंधु।
एंड यस बजे, लेट मी रिमाइंड यू, आज कोविड शेल्टर इन प्लेस करके स्टार्ट होके, मार्च में स्टार्ट हुआ था, 287 days of sheltering in place, and of course we have to do more, has been advised, and after Biden comes, probably he'll ask us to wear masks for 100 more days.
Oh my God.
Has the shelter in place been lifted? No, it hasn't. They've given the freedom to us, they're making us more responsible to make sure we take charge of our own life, but the point is they have guidelines to make sure we don't actually celebrate. In fact, a very disturbing thing is the surge happening over here in California is crazy. It's just crazy. It's like, you know, it's like it's one of the all-time highs of ever since the pandemic hit us, right?
Mm-hmm.
So mindful of that, we are still in the purple area in Santa Clara County as well. Even Bay Area, of course, is also in the purple area. That Bay Area, which covers the Sur County, covers a part of the Alameda County and everything, right? We all are pretty much in that kind of a purple area. So please be very mindful of your partying requirements or needs, whatever is that. If you're going to party, party at home probably. You can party on Zoom if you want it. All right, whatever, up to you guys. You know, welcome to the New Year the right way. The best way is to welcome with the safe way, is what I'm thinking. And that was, okay.
No, not going to safe way.
Well, no, Falconi, you actually can go to safe ways, maintain the physical distancing, wash your hands, wear gloves, wear a mask for sure, please, if you don't mind.
Okay.
And right now, let's go see what's happening in the roads. Raste ka haal, aapke liye lata hai, hum log, aate hai hum log, saste mein.
Right.
It's time for the Bandhu Traffic Update. Call us from wherever you are at 408-912-2479.
I don't know, again, people are getting back on the roads, probably because tomorrow is Christmas Eve, people are driving to destinations. You know, Falta, I just heard one more thing. I think it's becoming like a pattern.
Oh,
people are not spending time in going to these places where they go to, generally they go to parties and all, right?
Yeah.
They're not doing that as in, not going to public places where they're going to ball drop and all stuff.
Uh-huh.
But they're planning trips with friends and families. Different destinations.
Yes.
Airbnb and that Arbo.
You're not supposed
Verbo, all those things. No, you're not supposed
VRBO.
To.
VRBO.
It's called, they go by the name Verbo. They want to be called Verbo.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Okay.
And let me advise you, if at all you're doing that, watch out, drive very carefully because there's some fog on the north side. It is on 101 northbound and southbound, actually, on the Golden Gate Bridge. It's got some fog advisory there. There is mention of two traffic accidents of 101 northbound and southbound, actually. Incidentally, both are actually one next to each other, very close by. It's Marsh Road ke aas paas mein is one accident. Center lane is blocked over there. And also, going up a little bit further on north, Woodside Road on Redwood City is having two incidents to report for you guys on 101. Otherwise, the roads are looking pretty much smooth. That's very nice. If you want to know what's the temperature outside, well, Bajan, it's going to be sunny all the way until noon probably, or 1 p.m. And later on, it's going to get a little bit cloudy. We might have some clouds tomorrow and precipitation, as we might have some rain Saturday and Sunday. Chances of rain are higher, Faltrani, on Saturdays. So probably... And also Sundays. And also definitely Monday. Monday for sure will have rain.
Uh-huh.
Sunday you'll have some little bit of rain. And then of course Saturday. Weekend is going to be raining. Well, New Year's Eve, what's going to happen? New Year's Eve is tomorrow, right?
It is tomorrow, yes.
So probably we'll be welcoming some clouds in the next day. So Friday is going to be a little bit cloudy.
Oh, really?
Yeah. But you know, but then tomorrow's going to be a sunny day. Nevertheless, if you want to actually do welcome the New Year earlier. I don't know. Do you like to do the New Year's the day before? Can we do New Year's the day before?
Uh-huh. Yeah, I think so. We can't celebrate New Year's on 31st, but we'll obviously... I don't know, what sort of a question is that, Altu Baba?
A very good question to think about, Banjan. Can we celebrate the New Year earlier or later?
Uh-huh.
Question is that. Can you ring in the New Year on 30th night? That's tonight?
Maybe if it is already the New Year some part of the world.
Well, or can you ring in later, like, you know, on the 1st of January? Can you do that? I don't know. On the eve of 1st and 2nd, can we ring in the New Year that time? I don't know. I'm asking you a question, genuine question, Falconi. Socha nahi aapne kabhi?
सोचा है
नहीं फालतू नहीं 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 दस्ती फॉर सॉन्ग आई वाज गोना से व्हाटएवर इट इज डोंट वरी फिकर नॉट
या
डू व्हाटएवर कम्स टू माय बजट बिकॉज़ पैंडेमिक सिचुएशन में इट्स सो डिफरेंट राइट नाउ यू कैन डू जस्ट अबाउट एनीथिंग आई जस्ट लर्न दैट दिस इज पैंडेमिक फालतू नहीं इट इज नॉट पॉइंट गेटिंग थिंग्स राइट फालतू नहीं हो जो होना सो होना अरे मजे ले लो एंजॉय चिंता करके क्या फायदा बोले जान जस्ट यू नो टेक अ डीप ब्रेथ एंजॉय
ओ चिंता करके क्या पाएगा मरने से पहले मर जाएगा ओ चिंता करके क्या पाएगा मरने से पहले मर जाए
From the movie Baldan Chichore, which actually released this year, and unfortunately we lost Sushant Singh Rajput this year, Budhujan. And of course, the big news about everything, what happened, we don't know what happened for sure, 100%, nobody knows about it, but of course, we will remember him in the good ways, Manoj, we will remember him with the work he's done for us, the song also, in fact, its lyricist, jo hai, Faltrani, is Amitabh Bhattacharya,
right.
And music by Preetham, very nicely done, in fact, I like the way this song also is made. Mm-hmm. Two generations meeting, Faltrani.
Yeah.
It's imagine, I always thought of it, right? What will your older generation tell you?
Yeah.
What I used to wonder.
Yeah.
And now I know what it's going to be.
Yeah.
My older generation, let me just do whatever you want, dude. You're not going to bubble for much, man. Anything much anyways. Hey, that does not mean you got to be careless, Bindujan. I'll tell you what. You got to be careless. Fikar not does not mean being careless. Fikar not is not to tension, not to take tension, Bindujan. You should care. Because you care is, you know, is when you actually mean you're a human being, right? You should care for other people. But fikar not, don't fikar about it. Like, you know, oh my God, oh no, what's going to happen? Economy is going to tank. No, do all those things, Bindujan. Just live, take a deep breath. Just make sure your loved ones are loved more than give them love. That's what's care all about. Care is about giving love. So don't be careless, but just don't figure too much, Bindujan. That's what we request you guys anyways, Bindujan. Kanya Kida with Janani is a little bit different right now. As you know, coming to the end of the year, this is going to be the last but one good morning day for you guys for 2020. What's going to happen 2021? Now, that's always been a question for me as to what we do differently in 2021. Faltwani, I have something which I want to do differently in 2021.
What do you want to do, Alta Baba?
Good morning, babe. We'll have a totally different look, Bindujan. 2021.
Oh, wow. Mm-hmm. What, Alta Baba? In 2 days?
2 days? In 1 day, Faltwani.
1 day? Oh, yeah.
Today is done. Tomorrow is 31st, Faltwani. I know.
Yeah.
Of course, I can't make the news updates come to you a little bit earlier, but of course, before the news updates, has something interesting also, Bindujan. That's what I'm going to tell you. Because news updates today heavily reliant on our news consolidator, who's actually busy right now typing away on Facebook right now instead of actually looking up the news now. But anyways, Bindujan, that'll happen on 9:30 for sure. But we will have a new look for Good Morning Bay.
Like, what does a new look mean, Altua?
Surprise! Surprise!
Oh, you're going to give me a new news desk? Like, with all the ding-ding-ding-ding like that? Like, the thing coming?
Yeah, for the 15 minutes which you come in the show, I'll do it. That's no problem. 9:40, you come, I can have this ready for you. Okay, yeah, that's done, Faltwani. Okay, Bindujan, that's done. So, we'll hire a new desk for her, so she can actually work on the new desk.
Bye, Altua Baba. Nicely digested now, what you ate.
What do you, Faltwani? My God, look at that. You know, you have this thing, like, animosity. You have that, you know, anger in you, but seething in you. Like, it gets come face in your dialogue also. Hey, Bindujan, right now, let me tell you, we're going to go into our news updates with Faltrani, who's actually consulted the news for us very nicely. Thank you so much, Faltrani, for doing that every day of 2021. You've done this meticulously for us. Monday, ho, ya Friday, always there with our news updates for us. So, Faltrani, let's go. What's the headlines for today?
I have more than the headlines, Altababa.
Oh my god, so you also have a neckline?
What? What does neckline mean, Altu?
You said headline, I said neckline. So
whatever.
More than the headline is what neckline, right?
Yeah, whatever. Anyway, Banijan, let's tell you in terms of the coronavirus, the US has hit a new dismal daily coronavirus record with 3,725 deaths recorded as of yesterday. Again, another unthinkable number. Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell has blocked off an effort to boost forthcoming stimulus checks from $600 to $2,000, despite demands from President Trump and the opposition from prominent congressional Republicans. President-elect Joe Biden's transition team is clashing with the current administration, adding more mistrust and conflict to what is supposed to be a smooth exchange of power. Argentina's Senate has approved a bill to legalize abortion in the Catholic-majority country. New details on the Christmas Day bombing in Nashville have been few and far between as investigators try to piece together why the 63-year-old Anthony Quinn Warner detonated a bomb that injured three and severely damaged buildings historic of 2nd Avenue North. Mm-hmm. Legendary French fashion designer Pierre Cardin has died at the age of 98. Donald Trump, Michelle Obama are top the Gallup's 2020 most admired list. Netflix's Bridgerton had an intimacy coordinator apparently to stage some of those scenes that were there in that, but apparently it is being as a very dull although it was highly popularized. And in news from India, Banijan, government and the farmers have reached consensus on two issues, and their next meeting is on Jan 4th, according to Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar. The this is news from the headline that's coming out just now, Banijan. A newly elected U.S. congressman who was supposed to be sworn in as of this year, I think in 2 days, he passed away from COVID-19. We'll give you more details on that. Other news from India, the Union Cabinet has approved the export of the Akash missile system. ISRO chairman Sivan gets 1 year extension, says that the space reforms is his highest priority. And also in terms of the vaccine authorization in India, the COVID-19 vaccine authorization, CDSCO expert panel is going to be reconvening on Jan 1st to consider emergency use authorization for COVID vaccines. And Prime Minister Narendra Modi says that new Vista Dome coaches will make train travel even more memorable in India. So more on all this will be coming up shortly, Banijan.
Yes, Banijan, we'll get the news in detail for you guys for sure. But let me tell you one thing. There's some news which I want to share with you guys regarding taxes and everything. Banijan, I'll tell you what. If you are not done your taxes, if you're not actually in the process of doing it, there's something which you should know. We got our information from one of our bandhus. We verified it through our sources as well. About the fact that if at all you make a donation to a non-profit, right? I think you have a lot of, call them tax breaks, is what they call it?
Yeah.
Yeah, and this is the time. In fact, COVID situation, they actually are trying to help, the state is trying to help many profits. So what's going to happen is when you donate, I think up to $300, they actually give you a tax break somewhere. That I don't know much about the thing, but what we can definitely do is link you to our HEMA page where you can get more information on those, because people are thinking about taxes and everything, and now biggest headache is going to happen for the federal and also our tax collectors, I should say, because what about the income? How do people actually going to pay taxes this time?
Right.
The stimulus part of it also, we get more information on that. I think it didn't pass through, right? The $2,000 is not going to come anyway, right? So $600 only.
Well, yeah, it's only $600. We don't know. I'll get you more information about that. I just had a story that I pulled up from CNN, so I can talk a little bit more about that. Thanks to Mitch McConnell, you can wait a few more days for the remainder, the $2,000 to come in.
So it's going
to
happen next year only, Baljan, for all you know. And again, next year, though, what I'm looking forward to is Jan 20th and what's going to happen at that time. And yes, if at all you are in the area where you actually can donate or you're you're in a particular situation, financial situation, you can donate. I would like to think about pragnia.org, Brindajan. It's an organization working in the space of neurodiversity, welcoming neurodiverse individuals into the neurotypical world, and also vice versa, Brindajan. So inviting neurotypical world like you and I into the realm of neurodiversity. And this is all done through volunteer-driven activities, Brindajan. I'm not kidding. That's a wonderful activity that happened this year. In spite of COVID, they got creative, and you know, should actually hand it to Falthwani, who actually is one of the main driving force particular venture. It's very nice initiative. I don't even venture, I would say initiative. If you want to get more information, go to pragnya.org, pragnya.org, Brindajan, and you can actually get information. And again, now, Brindajan, let me tell you, if you have to, if you want to know more about the news and everything, the news in detail is coming up right about now.
That's right, Brindajan. Things are going to drag on in the Senate for a few more days. Bottom line, there's absolutely no sign right now that a standalone bill on the $2,000 check is going to get a vote on the Senate floor. It looks like Mitch McConnell is simply going to run out the clock on this one. There were several opportunities on Tuesday when McConnell could have made that assurance or let Democrats pass the bill with a unanimous consent agreement that would have shielded his members from having to take a potentially tough vote. But McConnell blocked those efforts. Instead, he gave himself an out card down the line, only if he needs one, by placing on the calendar a bill that would tie a repeal of Section 230 to increasing direct stimulus payments to $2,000 for Americans under a certain income level. The Kentucky Republican may never bring it up, and it is there just in case he needs to put something on the floor. Democrats were furious, and there is nothing that they can do about it unless they get the Senate majority. Meanwhile, Treasury Secretary Steve Mnuchin tweeted that direct payments to Americans were expected to begin arriving immediately, and this would be the $600 payments included in the relief package President Donald Trump signed on Sunday evening. There's something going on between McConnell and Trump. I don't know what it is, but he is essentially ignoring Trump's request at this particular moment.
Oh, really? I think you know what happened? Trump called him a name, right? He called him some Mitchie something, something Mitchie Mitchie. I'm sure he would have done it.
I don't think he's called him a name directly. Trump wouldn't dare to do that.
Excuse me, please. Supreme Leader can do anything, okay? He doesn't care about repercussions because Supreme Leader is beyond
that. Let me add, Brindajan, Altu Baba is sarcastic. It is not that he supports any one particular person or he thinks of Trump as a Supreme Leader.
Hello, Trump? It doesn't matter what I think. Trump thinks he's Supreme Leader, okay. So I acknowledge that about him.
If you say so, Altu Baba.
Why not? Oh my God.
Okay. In the meanwhile, let us tell you, Brindajan, I told you about the coronavirus cases. The U.S. has hit a dismal daily coronavirus records, like I mentioned before, with 3,725 deaths reported as of yesterday. Mm-hmm. One epidemiologist said the U.S. is now past the point of waves and spikes and is in the middle of what they call a viral tsunami.
Viral tsunami is the word. Wow.
The new COVID-19 variant, the first COVID-19 variant, Brindajan, has found its way into the United States. Remember the one that we talked about in the UK, which was a mutant?
Yeah.
Well, that the first case has been recorded in Colorado. The new variant spreads more quickly, but does not appear to be more deadly, though. Mm. That's what they're saying.
Mm-hmm.
Meanwhile, health officials are concerned over the slow rollout of tens of millions of vaccine doses. The federal government's Operation Warp Speed promised that 20 million doses would be administered before January 1, but only 11 million have been distributed and just over 2 million have actually been given to people.
I know one thing, Manjali, I'll tell you what is a bright, the light tunnel, let's say, right?
Mm-hmm.
We used to have 55 counties which were in the purple.
Mm-hmm.
One of the counties actually has turned to substantial or lesser level,
okay,
which is the county of Humboldt.
Okay, in a way it's good, right?
In a way it's good. Good news. Like they actually are spreading. But of course, nevertheless, the ICU availability is what I'm actually checking right now here. But again, that's what is a little bit disturbing because we have not gotten people out of the ICU still. We still are at 10% availability of ICUs at San Clemente and in the Bay Area region, which covers a bunch of counties actually. So you got to be mindful of that. And of course, if you want to know exactly what's happening in Santa Clara County, well, Manjali, Santa Clara County, if you look at it, I don't know, yeah. It's the same thing. Like we are, in, every day it's exponentially increasing. We are like a 1.7% increase since yesterday. The 2 days ago, I wouldn't say yesterday, but data's from yesterday, actually. Mm-hmm. So we have around 1,100 new cases reported every day,
pretty much.
As, of the 66,000 cases being reported in Santa Clara County alone. Statewide, if you look at it, it's in the same range. Statewide also, but it's like around 31,000 cases are reported on a daily basis statewide, Banjan. We hit around 2.18 new cases and total deaths. Unfortunately, we had around 242 deaths from the coronavirus case itself. But totaling almost close to around 25,000 in the state of California alone.
So are coronavirus lockdowns going to extend in California? Yesterday, Governor Newsom was saying that it's going to happen in Southern California. How's it looking in the rest of California?
Southern California or...
No, are the lockdowns extending?
Lockdown extension is left to the counties now, Fatwani. They've given the freedom to the local authorities to decide that. But right now, Saracodi decided that we're going to still remain in purple until further notice.
Okay, but...
So, until Jan 4th, we actually are in purple.
Meaning we're going lockdown mode.
Lockdown mode, yeah. They've not come out and said no open lockdown mode because we still are in a bad situation in terms of the increase of. I just told you the increase of 1.7% every day, Fatwani. It's like around approximately around 1,000 people coming up with positive cases, like tested positive.
Right.
That's disturbing, right?
Yeah. Well, what else is disturbing, Manishan? President-elect Joe Biden's transition team is clashing with the current administration, adding more mistrust and conflict to what is supposed to be a smooth exchange of power. Earlier this week, Biden said his transition team had encountered roadblocks from political leadership at the Defense Department and the Office of Management and Budget and isn't getting all the information that it needs to prepare. The Trump administration says Biden was overstating things. At the same time, people close to the transition efforts say critical information about budgets, U.S. force posture, recently announced troop withdrawal plans, and recent cyber attack attributed to Russia are being withheld. Trump officials have also openly admitted to being wary of the transition activity that could give the Biden administration a head start on dismantling Trump-era policies like the border wall construction. In the meanwhile, Banujan, let us tell you that we are thinking that, oh yes, Joe Biden is going to be affirmed. Remember I told you there's going to be a vote on in Congress, which is merely a formality. Remember that?
Mm-hmm.
Where President-elect Joe Biden will be, will be affirmed by Congress certifying the win. Missouri Republican Senator Josh Holloway said on Wednesday that he is going to object when Congress counts the Electoral College votes next week, which will force lawmakers in both the House and the Senate to vote on whether to accept the results of President-elect Joe Biden's victory. So it is still not over, Bandijan. Holly is the first senator to announce plans to object to the results, which is significant because both a House member and a senator are required to mount an objection when Congress counts the Electoral College votes on January 6th. The objection will not change the outcome of the election, only delaying the inevitable affirmation of Biden's victory in November over President Donald Trump. Democrats will reject any objections in the House, and multiple Republican senators have argued against an objection that will provide a platform for Trump's baseless conspiracy theories, claiming that the election was actually stolen from Hawley's objection, which other senators may still join, will also put many of his Senate Republican colleagues in a difficult political position, forcing them to vote on whether to side with Trump or with the popular will of the voters. And Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell privately urged Senate Republicans not to join the group of House members who are planning to object. Senate Majority Whip John Thune argued against it publicly, prompting a rebuke from Trump on Twitter and the threat of a primary challenge. So you can actually go read up on that on MediaMahima.com. In the meanwhile, Banujan, a newly elected Republican congressman from Louisiana became one of the highest-ranked politicians to die from COVID-19-related complications on Tuesday.
My God. Where was this place?
In Louisiana. Even as officials in Colorado reported the first known case in the U.S. of the coronavirus variant that first surfaced in Britain, Luke Letlow was only 41 years old. He was an aide to the Indian-American GOP veteran Bobby Jindal, and he died of a cardiac event, is what the doctor said, and was not linked to any previous underlying heart condition but was COVID-related. Letlow had announced that he had tested positive on December 18th and was admitted to the hospital the next day. And according to his office, and was placed in the ICU on December 23rd, where he was treated with remdesivir and steroids. He appeared to be recovering before a sudden cardiac event ended his life just days before he was to be sworn to Congress, where Republican lawmakers have largely been disdainful of the coronavirus.
And then if you're wondering about the vaccines, they are stalling out and it's pretty slow. And seems like the common man is going to get it only somewhere in spring, is what they're saying.
Not spring, it's going to go out to fall.
Oh,
yeah.
That's right. The update was on fall. They're going to be, but of course, the immediate people who are getting it are the emergency workers, and also the essential workers are...
And people in long-term care facilities.
Yep. Like, and there also is a lot of discussion about who is getting what and the issues of it also. We'll share some stories with you guys on MediaMahima.com.
Britain on Wednesday became the first country in the world to approve the coronavirus vaccine developed by Oxford University and AstraZeneca, hoping that rapid action will help it stem a record surge of infections driven by a highly contagious form of the virus. So we've got one more virus from AstraZeneca that is coming out. Also, Bhutajan, let's tell you that in news with regard to... the California coronavirus lockdowns, they have been extended as hospitals teeter on the brink of a crisis right now. Strict stay-at-home orders were renewed indefinitely on Tuesday for much of California, a leading U.S. hotspot of the COVID-19 pandemic. Its top health officials said that many hospitals were really teetering on the brink of this crisis.
And that means the particular thing is the fact the counties are still restricting. So there's no definite date actually specifies to until they tell us when it's opening up. But right now it's still closed. So please, for some more time, adhere to these things, because we need to control the spread of it and make sure everybody gets, at least the majority of us, start getting the vaccines.
Right. And in news from India, Bhutajan, regarding the farmers' protest, Agriculture Minister Narendra Singh Tomar has said that the government has agreed to resolve the concerns of protesting farmers over the rise in power tariff and penalties for stubble burning. However, the deadlock over the main issues on the repeal of three farm laws and a legal guarantee for minimum support price is still open, and it's still continuing. And government representative, 41 farmer unions held the sixth round of discussions. They're going to have another round of discussions on January 4th. And the Prime Minister Narendra has talked about a new Vista Dome coach that will train travel even more memorable. And if you want to see pictures of this, Bhutajan, it features larger viewing area, including rooftop glass and 44 seats for passengers that can rotate up to 180 degrees completely on their 180 kilometers per hour trial, on which ran on Tuesday. So catch up on all of this, Bhutajan, you can go to MediaMahima.com. That's all we have time for on this morning's Good Morning Bay. Stay safe, stay healthy, and stay happy. We'll see you tonight live at 5 on the Pam Pam Show.
Que yo